Why hello here. So in this video, we will be going through a basic tutorial for Jane's Scene Builder, which is a tool add-on for RPG Maker MV. If you don't know about Jane already, it's an official tool that allows us to create picture events more visually. So first of all, I'm going to play this scene I made in Jane, and afterwards I'll continue talking. That is it for the scene, and welcome back. Now, we're not going to discuss how I made this. That was just a showcase on the sort of cutscene you can make very easily with Jane. In this video, we will only be going through the basics of the tool. So let's begin. After we launch Jane, we first have to go into File and associate an MV project with it. This allows it to bring up assets from that project into the visual eventing we will be doing. The first and most important of these events is the Show Picture event. We can add a picture to it and it will instantly show on the preview screen. On that note, let's go through the different sections of the editor. We have a timeline at the bottom, where all our events go. On the right, we have a section for properties for the event we are working with. And in the middle is the preview screen, so we can instantly see our events visualized right as we work on them. On the preview screen, we have the picture we just added. Through the timeline, we can drag around the event to a different position. We can change its duration. We can copy paste it. And through the preview, we can move the picture around with the mouse. We can resize it however we like, and you can notice the properties on the right change as we work on the picture. Now I'm going to drag and resize the picture again, but this time I will hold the Alt key. If I click play, we can see what I just did. So there are two parts to picture events, the start position and end position, how the picture looks when the event starts and how it looks when the event ends. The start position is represented by a purple frame in preview, whereas the end position is represented by a green frame. Any edits we make to the picture in the preview happen simultaneously to both start position and end position, but if we hold the Alt key, we can work on them separately. Looking at our right, we have some more options in the properties section. We can also change picture number ID, opacity, blend, and rotation. There is a feature to tint the picture as well, but it's limited because we can only select tint for the end position and not the start. Moving on, for adding more pictures in the scene, we have to create a new lane in the timeline. By clicking the blank white paper in the bottom right, a new lane is created, where we can add another picture event. Let's move on to the second most important event in Jane, the Show Text event. It works exactly the same as in RPG Maker. We can add a face, change window background and position, add text codes, the only difference is how we add multiple show text events to our timeline. We can't change the show text duration on the timeline, so if we place another show text event right after a show text event, then there is a big gap in the middle. So we have to create a new lane and put the next show text one frame after from where the previous show text starts. This method is only if you are using different face for each show text event. If we are only showing text, then we can work inside just one event, as the show text event in Gene works like a batch entry. So it has infinite number of lines in the editor and it pops up a new message after every 4 lines. Now that we have discussed show picture and show text, we'll be dashing through the rest. A standard scroll text event, a screen effect event with flash color that basically works as replacement for fading in, and an option to add shake to the whole scene. We can add any sort of sound with the audio event. We can fade out BGMs with the audio fade out event. There is a marker event for adding comments to our scene. And there are presets. We can create some sort of event or animation in this scene, then save it as a preset by clicking on File in the top menu bar. We can then call the event anywhere in any scene. At the bottom right, we have undo and redo buttons, adding lane, play preview, pause, zoom in or out the timeline, and a button for copying the scene so we can then paste it into our ME project. An important thing I missed is when you click on an empty space around the preview, the scene property pops up on the right, where we can select the resolution. Do note, we can't select a resolution smaller than the default. It can only be higher. You can save and load a scene as well. Zoom in and out the preview using Ctrl plus and Ctrl minus. Expand the timeline . Change the theme of the UI to white . And that's pretty much it for this tutorial . In my post-tutorial rant, I would like to mention a few more things. Like, you really want to learn all the shortcut keys if you're using Gene, as it massively improves workflow. For some technical reasons, what you see in preview does not match exactly when you copy-paste the scene into RPG Maker. so you may need to do small fixing in the scene when you're done. There is no event command for adding choices in genes, so that has to be done inside RPG Maker instead. And you really want to polish the scene inside Gene, because making edits to picture events after copying it into RPG Maker is a bit awful. The evented version of a scene we make in Gene has a lot of unnecessary bloat. For example, even if we do not apply any tint or rotation in our picture events, the event command for it will still show up in RPG Maker, with zero or default value. It is extra bloat, which makes it a bit more complicated to make edits. My overall review of this tool is that Gene is literally the easiest and fastest way to create a simple visual novel. I have used a bit of Tarano Builder and Visual Novel Maker, and neither of them are as good in terms of speed and workflow. They are more flexible, and so working on them is a bit more slow. Gene is very limited, which was frustrating when I was starting out, but after understanding its limits and getting used to them, I'm enjoying using it more, and have absolutely fallen in love with it.